I felt like she'd looked right through me. All of those descriptions, I understood. They were a picture of me. Then she said there wasn't anything she could really do for me. I was too old to be taught new ways of thinking. But she added that I was amazingly self-taught, that I had thought of creative solutions to nearly every way that were stumbling blocks for me in finding my way through my education career. Not to mention, I had used this creative problem-solving skill to find my path to her, to answer my question. So now I was happy and unhappy. Of course, she noticed that and recommended that I speak to her teacher, the professor and head of the apartment at the College of Mount St. Joe in Cincinnati. So I made an appointment, and I felt like I walked backwards to the College of Mount St. Joe to meet with the guru. She was wonderful. She told me after a brief interview that there was nothing wrong with me, that I had a beautiful and wonderful and creative mind. She was honest. She told me there would be some things I would never be able to do well. She implored me to think about my gifts and that this dyslexia was a gift to me. She said I would be aided if I had a secretary. Okay, I understood that, but as a college student, how could I do that? She said, you'll figure it out. And she was right. All of this wonderful advice cost me nothing except my time. But what it gave to me was so well worth it. I am forever indebted and grateful for the time that those people gave to me. I didn't know at the time, but in the years to come, my secretary would be mostly my computer. Thou hast only to follow the wall far enough, and there will be a door in it. I feel like I'm a survivor. Still, so many are not. If you are so unfortunate to receive a direct hit on your self-confidence, there's not much to be done. However, if you are not directly hit, but had a close call, and you're a survivor, you know you can withstand nearly anything. For me, my disability has become my ability. It has given me a path, a renewed way of thinking. It is my gift for creative problem solving, for a tenacity that never feels failure is an obstacle, only something to work through. Now I think anew and I see anew. In the books I make, I hope I do that for my readers. A prudent person avoids unpleasant things, but a wise man overcomes them.